Brianna Renee, and today's video is very personal, obviously. And it also happens to be a pretty recent story. This only happened like 2 months ago, so I can't believe I'm sharing it already, but here I am. Although this is a very recent story, I feel like I've gone through a lot with sex and virginity and like figuring out what it all meant to me and what I needed to be like that intimate with another person. It was always so confusing to me. And I feel like this story kind of explains all the different mindsets I had and what I needed to like get to that place with someone. So I think it's interesting. I hope you guys enjoy it. It's not meant to be like super raunchy. It's more like big sister-y, but there's definitely some tea in there also. I don't know. I like this video, I hope you guys do too, and let's just hop right into it.
I've shared this before, but I grew up in a Christian school with Christian parents, went to church every Sunday. I truly lived in a bubble, and up until the age of 14, I honestly thought just about everyone waited until marriage. It was instilled in me from a young age that having sex was an intimate thing that should be saved for my husband. When I was 16, I had my first kiss with my first boyfriend. I remember feeling a little bit uneasy because he had already slept with multiple people, so we definitely wanted to move at different paces. And this is something I continue to struggle with over the years, with different guys who came into my life. Up until I was 18, I was planning on waiting till marriage. Then I thought, maybe I just need a long-term relationship with someone I'm in love with. Then maybe just someone who cares for me and will be there the next morning. Over the coming years, sex was always a very confusing topic for me. I never knew what was right or wrong, what I needed from another person, or how I would feel after losing my virginity. Our story starts in October of 2018. I took a trip to Toronto to visit my friend Chloe and spent a Halloween weekend with her. On that Friday, we went to a bar, rode a mechanical bull, and had a ton of fun. While we were out, Chloe texted a guy, let's call him Ryan. So Chloe texted Ryan because she left something at his place last time she was there and she wanted to stop by and get it before heading home. Luckily, Ryan was at a bar a few doors down from us, so we went there to meet up with him. That is when I met his friend, let's call him Eric. And Eric is the guy who swiped my virginity, but let's not get too ahead of ourselves. Eric introduced himself to me and asked where my Halloween costume was. I told him I was dressing up tomorrow night as a pirate and he replies, oh, so you'll be one of the 1 million pirates in Toronto. And I said, yeah, but I'll be the cutest one. And apparently he found that charming. At this point, it was a little after 1 a.m. and we were all feeling pretty hungry. So Eric invited us over to his apartment for avocado toast and poached egg. I was impressed when we got to Eric's apartment. It wasn't massive, but it was very nice, clean, well decorated, and had an amazing view of the CN Tower. Chloe, Brian, and I all sat on the couch while Eric prepared the toast. We decided to play some video games while we were waiting for the food. I kept peering over at Eric though. There was just like something intriguing about him to me. I don't know. I just don't know too many guys who would prepare avocado toast for their guests at 2 in the morning. The toast was amazing and Eric and I started having some really good conversations. We talked about my job, our families, what I was doing in Toronto, food. The more we talked, the more it became clear that we are both really feeling each other. Based on our body language and eye contact, I knew he was gonna kiss me. I was just waiting for him to make the move. He made me wait for a bit, but eventually he did kiss me and I was very, very happy. Not too long afterwards, Chloe and Ryan headed out to get what she left at his place, but I decided to stay back with Eric. He put on some music and candles and things started to go a little bit further, so I felt I needed to let him know that I wasn't gonna have sex with him. He said okay, then asked why, and I told him I was a virgin. I could tell by his face that that wasn't the answer he was expecting. In the age of dating apps and easy hookups, it's not all that common to meet someone who's a virgin at the age of 20, so I was pretty used to getting that kind of reaction. After a couple hours of being at his place, I decided I should be headed back to Chloe's for the night. Before I left, Eric asked what I was doing the next night and expressed that he would love to see me again. Now, I'm not proud of this because it was extremely douchey on my end, but I did feel very put on the spot in that moment, so I told him he couldn't reserve me for 2 nights, then patted him on the head in an attempt to soften the blow. Eric was amazing, but I was only in Toronto for a weekend and I didn't know what my plans were and I didn't want to feel tied down the next night, especially because it was Halloween weekend. So on that note, I called the Uber to head back to Chloe's. The next day, Eric texted me being very sweet, trying to make plans for that night. He even offered to make me pancakes if I stopped by, but unfortunately, I kind of blew him off. I told him I didn't know what my plans were and not to wait around for me as I probably wouldn't make it. That night, I ended up going to a Halloween party, then a bar, and had a really fun night dancing with my friends. While I was out, Eric texted me again to see if I was interested in his offer. I didn't reply, but then 2 a.m. rolled around and I couldn't stop thinking about him. So I hit him with the dreaded "you up" text. Luckily, I caught him about 10 minutes before he was about to sleep. He told me to come over and started preparing the pancakes. When I got there, he was even cuter than I remembered. We sat in the kitchen for a while as he made pancakes for us, and he even made a heart-shaped one for me. I ended up staying the night this time, but I was very much still a virgin the next morning. I woke up bright and early, ready to leave, but Eric told me to stay a while as he prepared me breakfast in bed. I really was not used to being treated so well. If you've seen any of my past drama lives, you probably know how tragic my love life has been, and those relationships definitely caused me to turn a little bit cold. Eric was different though, and I started to feel bad for blowing him off the way I did. 5 minutes later, Eric walks back into the room with grilled cheese, a glass of water for me, and I was so happy. Before this, the only person I had ever had make me breakfast in bed was my mom, so it felt nice. I stayed for a bit, we cuddled, shared some good conversations, then I decided it was time for me to finally head out. I started to pack up my things to go, and that is when I had the realization that I was going to have to walk back through his fancy lobby in my pirate costume on a Sunday morning. Luckily, Eric was kind enough to give me one of his t-shirts so I would have a slightly less awkward walk through the lobby. I made it to the Uber and went back to Chloe's. That was the last time I saw Eric on that specific trip, and I still had no idea how much he would end up meaning to me. That Monday, I had a flight back home and I wore his t-shirt to the airport. Over the course of the next 2 months, Eric and I talked every single day, started FaceTiming regularly, and became really, really close despite being so far away. At first, I didn't really know what I was talking to Eric for. We lived a 2.5 hour plane ride away, and a long distance relationship was never something I wanted. But for the first time in my life, I could picture it, and I could see myself being happy in it. This became even more clear to me on my birthday. My 21st birthday completely sucked. I was in New York, which was fun, up until I got the news of a family member passing away. I ended up crying in the middle of a fast food restaurant with makeup streaming down my face. My birthday was pretty much ruined at that point. The only upside to my birthday is that that night I had one of the best conversations with Eric that I had ever had. The things we told each other that night definitely brought us closer and made me wish he could be by my side during this tough time. To really give this potential relationship a chance, I decided to book an 11-day trip to Toronto so I could see him again. About 2 weeks before my trip, we decided to become officially exclusive to each other, but we ended up finding out that neither of us had hooked up with anyone since meeting anyways. In January, I arrived at the Toronto airport and Eric was there waiting to pick me up. It was very exciting, but also strange seeing him there after 2 months of texting and FaceTiming. It was kind of like meeting a pen pal. He ran up and gave me a big kiss as soon as he saw me and helped me with my luggage. I was definitely a little bit shy at first. It was strange because we knew each other so well, we just weren't used to actually being around each other. We loaded the luggage into the car and headed back to his apartment, holding hands the whole way there. When we got up to his floor, things escalated pretty quickly. We really missed each other and it felt good to be together again. I don't want to give many details, but this is the moment I lost my virginity. We had talked about the possibility of it happening before, but I really didn't know if it would actually happen or not until I got there. In that moment, it just felt right though. I knew how much he cared about me and he made me feel safe. I definitely know he was the right person. After it was over, we got some snacks, cuddled up on the couch, and watched Shark Tank. I was pretty quiet trying to process everything that had just happened. I felt oddly the same, and life felt normal, which confused me. For some reason, I had it in my head that sex was this earth-shattering thing, that it would change me in some way, but it didn't. I felt the same, except I am now a person who has had sex. Eric and I went on to have an amazing 11 days together, filled with many long talks, amazing dates, and moments of hysterical laughter. I will say there's something very special about being that intimate with someone. Eric has become not only the guy I'm dating, but one of my best friends, and I've definitely never been this comfortable with anyone ever before in my life. When you guys are watching this video, I actually will have just come back from Toronto again after having a great Valentine's Day with Eric, who is now my boyfriend. So that is the story of how I lost my virginity. I know some people will judge my decisions. Maybe they think I should have waited longer, or I waited too long, or I should have waited till I was married. But for me, it felt right, and that's really all I know. I don't know what's right or wrong for any other person. If you want to wait till marriage, that's awesome. If you don't, that's cool too. Everyone should have the choice of what they want to do with their bodies, and today I chose to share the choice I made with you guys.
So that is the story of how I lost my virginity. I'm scared. I'm scared to put this out there, but I don't know, it's my story and I wanted to share it. Obviously, I'm not telling you guys what you should and shouldn't do, but I do feel like I made the right choice for me, and that's really all I know. So I'm going to leave it at that. I hope you guys got something from this video, whether you agree with me or you don't agree with me. I don't know, everyone's allowed to make their own choices. I made my choice. Subscribe for more story times like this or like other interesting videos. Follow me on Instagram, and oh my god, I'm talking different because I'm literally so nervous. I've never been this nervous for a video ever. I'm going to end it now. Hope you liked it. Bye.